Hey Jackalls, do you want to speed up the exports in DaVinci Resolve 17? Well, the best way to do that is to use a GPU. But the DaVinci Resolve 17 free version can't use it. Can you use anything else? Well, you can, if you absolutely want to. You can use something like Handbrake. We'll export the file as an MOV and then encode it as an MP4. Does that make any sense? Who knows? We'll find out. Well, let's get digital. When you have the project done, this is what we'll see. You'll want to give the file a name, set the location, and then change the format. By default, this is set to QuickTime. Usually, you'll just change it to MP4, add it to render queue, and render it out. And you'll get the file. But if you do it this way, well, let's just say that it takes a long time, as you can see. Anywhere from 12 minutes to 12 and a half minutes for this project. What you can do to speed this up is go down, click on Advanced, go down, click on Data Levels, set this to full. This will mean that you'll have the full color space and you'll want to use Render Cache. You can also use the proxy media if you made it, or optimized media if you made those. I didn't, so I'll just use Render Cache. And Render Cached images, this is what you see with this blue bar. If you have this, this will speed up the rendering. As you can see, it takes 3 minutes and it gets even faster. This 3 minutes and 4 seconds was with the MP4 setting. And this even faster time was with another setting. And how can you do that? Well, as you can see, this is an MOV file. To get an MOV file, you'll simply change this to QuickTime and you can use DNxHD. By default, this is the quality and you can leave it as is, or you can set it to any of the other options. 1080p, 36, 8-bit being the lowest quality. And leave the settings as is, so set it to full in data levels and also use render cache. If we take out the calculator, let's see what the difference is between these two. So 184 seconds divided by 163 seconds. So this was about 13% faster for a total of 21 seconds. But compared to this result, if I take the fastest and the fast one here, so this would be 11 times 60 plus 54, this many seconds divided by 163. And this was almost 4.5 times faster. Now we have a lot of fusion effects and color corrections and you can't see this blue bar. Simply go to Playback, Render Cache, and you'll either have to use User or Smart. Then just wait it out until the red bar turns to blue. One thing that you should know, if you export as an MOV file, the file size gets big fast. In this case, it's 13 GB, compared to the MP4 export of only 400 MB. But this was just one example, let me show you another example. Now in this example, as you can see, the difference is 17 seconds, and if I do this with percentages, this would be 139 divided by 122, almost 40% difference. And for the last example, and in this example, as you can see, let's just take this value of the MP4 and the lowest value of the MOV to get the biggest difference possible. This is 7 seconds in total. So 31 divided by 24, 29%. But as you saw, you won't get 29% all of the time. And even in this case, this just means 7 seconds. Now is that 7 to 21 seconds worth it? Well, let's take a look. So you'll open the handbrake and put the file in. I'll use this one because it's the biggest one and just so we can see the difference. So I'll put it in. What we'll want to do is to go to video, set the video encoder to H.264 NVIDIA. If you have an AMD GPU, you'll have to go to Tools, Preferences, Video, and check this box for AMD VCA encoders. Go back, set the FPS, in this case it can be set to same as source, then give the file a name and a path. So I'll put it to the same folder, save, and simply click Start Encode. If this is done quickly, you won't even be able to see the time, but in this case, it'll take about a minute and a half. So let's see how long it took. 1 minute, 27 seconds. Let's go take a look at the file. So this is the original one that the DaVinci Resolve exported. And this is the new one. As you can see, the file size is smaller, but the video should still be good enough. Looks fine to me, but you can have some issues, like in this example. This is the original with the DaVinci Resolve. What the issues you can have is, let's see, with this. As you can see, we have some fields, black and white, and some fields also at the top and here. Now, if you use the default settings in Handbrake, this is what can happen. I hope you can see it. We have some weird stuff going on, and this is not what you want to see. So if your video has something like that, we'll have to go to filters, the interlace, and set this to off. And when you do that, I've already done it, the video should look just fine. As you can see, we have just like original footage made with DaVinci Resolve. But now if I go back to this project, and we calculate the time needed to export in DaVinci Resolve versus DaVinci Resolve plus Handbrake, exporting as an MOV file can be a lot faster than exporting as an MP4 file. But if you take into consideration that you then also have to convert the MOV file to another format, that can be slower than just exporting as an MP4 file. But why would you export the video as an MOV file? Well, that's because you can archive it and convert it to another format anytime you want, without losing the quality. I hope this answered your question, like it did mine. And if you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more DaVinci Resolve and video editing content. And hit the bell notification icon so don't miss my next video. I'm Simon, and until next time, Jackalls, keep it digital.